Yeah, today I would like to discuss about demand and law of demand, demand schedule and demand curve, and individual demand and market demand. These are the concepts that I would like to discuss in today's lecture. Now, first, I would like to discuss about what is demand. This is the definition of demand. The definition of demand having a different meaning. So when you can say a commodity having a demand, yes, you can say a commodity having a demand, that commodity has to satisfy two conditions. What are the two conditions that commodity has to satisfy? First one is called desire. Second one is called ability to buy or capacity to buy. So that ability to buy or capacity to buy, you can express in terms of purchasing power of an individual or a consumer. So then only you can say that commodity having a demand. So this is the definition I would like to explain with help of example. Let me give that example in a detailed way. First, let me take first person. His name is called Jackson. Let us assume that Jackson is a poor fellow or a middle class man. Jackson, he would like to buy a Benz car. Let us assume that the price of Benz car may be, let us assume that 50 lakhs. So Jackson wants to buy a Benz car. So he is having strong desire to purchase a Benz car. But let us assume that he doesn't have money to buy the Benz car, because he is a middle class man, maybe poor person. So he doesn't have money to buy that Benz car. So he doesn't have 50 lakhs to buy the Benz car. So yes, in case of Jackson, yes, he doesn't have money to purchase a Benz car, but he's having strong desire to purchase a Benz car. Another person, his name is called Ronald. Yes, Ronald having lot of money, but Ronald doesn't want to buy this Benz car. Because let us assume that Ronald may have different brands of cars at his palace. So that is the reason he doesn't want to buy a Benz car, but he's having money to buy that Benz car. Maybe let us assume that 50 lakhs he's having. So in case of Ronald also, you cannot call a Benz car having a demand. And next one, Jack. He's a third person called Jack. Let us assume that Jack having a strong desire to purchase the Benz car, not only having a desire, is having a purchasing power also. Purchasing power means he's having 50 lakhs also in his hand. So yes, in case of Jack, you can say a Benz car having a demand. Here you have to understand, let me take three cases together. First case, Ronald. Second case, Jackson. Third case, Jack. These three people, in case of Ronald, yes, Ronald having strong desire, but he doesn't have purchasing power, which means that money. In second case, Ronald, yes, he doesn't have desire to purchase a Benz car, but he's having 50 lakhs of money, which means that he's having money. But in third case, in case of Jack, yes, he's having strong desire. At the same time, he's having purchasing power. What we have to get from these three cases? In first case, you cannot call Benz car having a demand. But in second case, yes, also you cannot call a Benz car having a demand. But in case of third case, Jack's case, yes, you can call a Benz car having a demand. Why you are telling in case of Jack, the Benz car having a demand? Because in first case, in the first slide itself, I told that, yes, when you can say a commodity having a demand, a commodity will be having a demand. It has to satisfy two conditions. First one, desire and purchasing power. In case of Jackson, is having desire and it doesn't have purchasing power. In case of Ronald, he doesn't have desire, but is having purchasing power. In third case, yes, in Jack case, Jack having purchasing power and desire to purchase the Benz car. In Jack's case, you can say that Benz car having a demand. But here, what you have to understand, then you can say a commodity having a demand. That's what I told in the first slide itself. A commodity having a demand, if a commodity has to satisfy two conditions, one is called desire, another one is purchasing power, then only you can say that that commodity having a demand. So in Jackson case, in Ronald case, we cannot call Benz car having a demand, because in first case, in case of Jackson, first condition has satisfied, but second condition didn't satisfy. So what is second condition? That is called purchasing power, because it doesn't have purchasing power. In case of Ronald, yes, he didn't satisfy the first condition, but he has satisfied the second condition. Which condition he didn't satisfy? He didn't satisfy the desire to purchase the Benz car. But in case of Jack, yes, he has satisfied both purchasing power and no desire to, but two conditions he has satisfied. That is the reason in case of Jack, you can say that commodity having a demand. So that is called demand in economics. Then you can say a commodity having a demand. So yes, you can able to say a commodity having a demand when a commodity able to satisfy two conditions. First one is desire, second one is purchasing power. Then only you can say that commodity having a demand. Now, after demand, I would like to discuss about law of demand. What do you mean law of demand? You know, the concept of law of demand has given by Alfred Marshall. And in case of law of demand, a law of demand will explain about price and demand. It will explain the relationship between price of the commodity and demand of the commodity. Yes, most of you people know that law of demands mainly state that there is inverse relationship between price and demand. What do you mean inverse relation, or what do you mean indirect relation, or what do you mean negative relationship between price and demand? Let us assume that I'm the person, I'm a consumer. I went to the market with 10 rupees. I'm having 10 rupees in my pocket. So I went to the market with the 10 rupees. Let us assume that price of the commodity, I went to the market, I have observed the price of the commodity. It is keep on increasing. Yesterday I brought some products and today I went to the market. Maybe suddenly the price of the commodity increased. Okay, whenever the price of commodity has increased, immediately I would like to reduce my demand because there is a high price. So when the price of the commodity is increasing, yes, I would like to reduce my demand. So maybe in the reverse case, when the price of the commodity is decreasing, as a consumer, as a rational consumer, I would like to increase my demand. So that is the reason there is a negative relationship between price and demand. But now, before I would like to explain about negative relationship between price and demand, Alfred Marshall clearly state that, yes, there is a negative relation between price and demand, but it is based on certain kind of assumptions. What are the assumptions? Assumptions are not, here is nothing but conditions. You know, yes, before you would like to express your law of demand, we have to take an assumption that all other things being constant. What are all other things? All other things are nothing but determinants of demand. What are the other things? You can say consumers' income, taste and preferences, advertisements. You can say maybe weather conditions, price of related goods. These are the other conditions. Whenever you're talking about law of demand, you have to take an assumption that all other things being constant, then only there is a negative relationship between, there is an inverse relationship between price and demand. That you people know very well, because as a rational human being, I would like to buy more commodities if there is low price. I would like to buy less commodities if there is a more price. Maybe reverse case, I would like to buy more if there is less price. So there is a negative relationship between price and demand. Now, here I would like to discuss about demand curve and demand schedule. Demand schedule is nothing but demand table. So even what do you mean this demand schedule? You know, demand schedule, it will explain the relationship between price and quantity demand. So if you see, you can observe from the table or in the schedule, you know, I have taken price of pizza and quantity demand of pizza per week. If you observe, when the price of commodity like pizza, it is increasing 15 rupees, 12 rupees, 9 rupees, 6 rupees, and 3 rupees. So when the price of commodity, the price of pizza is decreasing, obviously your demand is increasing, because you know that when price increases, demand, when price decreases, demand will increase. So at 15 rupees of pizza, they're buying 8 millions of pizzas. At 12 rupees, 14. So what is happening here? No, when the price decreasing, your demand is increasing. This is called demand schedule. You know, demand schedule, it will explain the relationship between different levels of price. What is the commodity demand? Okay, this is called demand schedule. You know, based on this demand schedule, we can able to draw the demand curve. Let me show the demand curve also. You know, on y-axis, I have taken price of pizza. On x-axis, I have taken, you know, or demand of pizza. You know, at 3 rupees price, how many, actually let me show the values also. At 3 rupees price of pizza, I'm buying 32 million pizzas. At 6 rupees price, 26 million. So all of you please observe from actually the same table that I am going to draw. I would like to draw the demand curve based on the table only. At 15 rupees, 8 millions, 12 rupees, 14 millions, 9 rupees, 20 millions. What you have to observe? As I said earlier, you know, when the price of commodity is decreasing, you're going to increase the level of demand. That's what you can observe from the figure also. So the A, B, C, D are the different levels of consumptions at different prices. If you add all these points, then you will get your demand curve A, B, C, D, E. If you add all these 5 points, then you will get DD is a demand curve. Now, what is the shape of the demand curve? The shape of the demand curve is a downward slope. It is a downward from left to right. This is the demand curve for pizza. Now, next I would like to discuss about individual demand and market demand. What do you mean individual demand and what is mean market demand? You know, especially in economics, if you look at the term, you will get half of the meaning. Individual demand and market demand. What do you mean individual demand? You know, in case of individual demand, you know, individual demand, it will explain different levels of demand of a particular person. Now, how a particular person demanding the product at particular price, at different prices, you know, that is called individual demand. Are you getting my point? You know, individual demand, it is mainly talk about, how a person behaving in the market. Generally, individual demand, it will explain how a particular individual, how is behaving in the market is called individual demand. Then what could be market demand? Market demand means how all persons, how all individuals, how they're behaving in the market, that will explain by the market demand. In case of market, we will talk about group of the people, group of the consumers. But in case of individual demand, we will talk about only single consumer or single individual. That is the main difference between individual demand and market demand. Let me give an example so that you will get clarity. So there are two types of demands. One is called individual demand. Another one is called market demand. Yes, this is individual demand schedule. Maybe you can say demand schedule of an individual person, because when you're talking about the individual demand, you're going to talk about only one person. That is the reason I have given only one person's demand here, 15 rupees. Same example I have taken here, but it's not per, maybe let me give one more example here. Wait a moment. Yeah, then we'll get clarity here. So this is the demand of individual person called Ram. This is a demand of individual person called Balu. This is a demand of individual person called Ramya. Are you getting my point here? What do you mean individual demand? Individual demand means how a particular person, how one individual behaving in the market is called individual demand. Here I'm talking about only one individual. See, actually, in order to give the example, I have mentioned three names here, but no need to focus on Balu and Ramya here. Just focus on Ram. You know, in case of individual demand, I would like to speak about only Ram. How Ram behaving in the market is called individual demand. So how Ram buying the products or how Ram demanding the products at different prices is called individual demand. You know, then what could be the market demand? You know, in case of market demand, if you add Ram's demand if you add Balu demand, if you add Ramya demand, then you will get market demand. Are you getting my point? Actually, the main difference between individual demand and market demand, in case of individual, you're going to talk about only one person, that is called ROM. But in case of market demand, you will talk about all individuals together. Let us assume that in this market, there are only three people in the market, Ram, Balu, and Ramya. So in case of individual demand, I will talk about only Ram, how he behaves in the market. But in case of market demand, I'm going to talk about not only Ram, I'll talk about Balu, I'll talk about Ramya. So how they're behaving in the market. So simply I can say that if I add demand of Ram, demand of Balu, demand of Ramya, then that is called market demand. So this is the difference between individual demand and market demand. Let me say clearly, individual demand, which mainly talk about individual person, market demand, it will talk about all persons together, all consumers together. That is the main difference between individual demand and market demand. So if you want me to know sum up what I have discussed till now, you know, in this lecture, just I have discussed about what is demand, what is law of demand, our shape of the demand curve, individual demand, and market demand. I have clearly mentioned that demand means the demand of particular commodity. It has to satisfy two conditions, desire and willingness to buy. In case of law of demand, yes, law of demand clearly explains about the relationship between price and demand based on certain kind of assumptions. You have to take an assumption that all other things being constant, there is a negative relationship between price and commodity demand. So after that, I have discussed about demand curve and demand schedule. Yes, demand schedule, it will show that how people demanding at different prices. Yes, there is a negative relationship between price and demand. So I have given the example of price of pizza. So the pizza price is increasing when pizza price is decreasing, people demanding more number of pizzas. So you know very well. So since there is a negative relationship between price of pizza and demand for pizza, so that is the reason the demand curve for pizza is a downward slope from left to right. After that, I have started discussing about individual demand and market demand. Individual demand mainly talk about an individual person, how he behaves in the market. In case of market demand, we will talk about group of individuals in the market. Thank you so much.